What's up? What's up?
Tell YouTube, welcome back to YouTube. Welcome back, YouTube. Welcome back.
Morning, guys. I'm just back from work. I'm heading to the sup store, work some more. Update on me. I busted my lower back yesterday doing some rack pulls. Don't ego lift and AMRAP your max nearly. So, yeah. I did it. I got 8 reps on 200, which was killer, but I'm feeling it today. This morning I did 2 clients. Now currently chilling with Lulu for like 10 minutes. Going to BSF till 1, and then I got to sit down, write down some programs or some shit, and play some Dragon Ball Z. But yeah, I'll take you through my day. I'm going to go over the topic of supplementation while I'm at the store today, so that should be good. I'll get my friend Adam probably involved in the video because he's the guru of supplementation, and I'll tell you the do's and don'ts and how to use your supplements to, I don't know, maximize your gains, maximize your shreds, maximize your life, all that sort of good stuff. So yeah, here we go. Let's go.
Do you want it? How bad do you want it? Do you want it? You want it? You want it? Oh! Alright. Sit. Lulu, sit. Sit. Stay. Stay. Hey! Stay. Hey!
Good girl. Get it.
Get it. Manja. All that manja. Like my Dragon Ball Z, you know?
Hey there, could I just get 1 stack of pancakes, please?
Not a problem, that was all.
Yes, please.
$4.95, drop down, you're ready.
Thank you. So I've currently rocked up at Casa de Gains, aka BSF. Like I said, just working here till 1, selling gains, busted back. So yeah, I've no idea if I'm going to train today. I was planning to train shoulders, so probably will still. I'll just put some deep heat, pop some codeine or something. But yeah, I'll walk you through some supplementation today. So a lot of people have a misconception of like, bro, like, what's the best gainer for me to get big? How much scoops of protein do I have to take a day? I'm like, bro, you gotta eat food, like, get some Maccas. It's loaded with carbs, well, pancakes are, and that'll help you more than a scoop of protein. So yeah, it's just crazy the misconception some days on, like, what people think about supplementation versus real food, just food in general, if you know what I mean. So yeah.
Look at this. Look at it. So this, I'm fasting, so this is my first meal, and it's easy 100 carb for me to get in. Look at it. The best.
So my current goal is currently put on size because I am bulking. I have to be eating over 3,500 calories at least. Between 3,500 to 4,500 calories, so I just got scared something there. But yeah, that's the main goal. Eating about 400 carb, about 120 fat, and about 180 protein a day. So yeah.
Oh,
is this? What fucked you up?
Okay, I trained legs yesterday, and then I went.
I trained her legs.
Just to get one thing straight, I train twice a day, so I'm fucked all the time. So cool. Today at F45, we had a sledgehammer. And we had to do jumping squats.
You have sledgehammers?
Oh, yeah, jumping squats like this. I can't even fucking jump right now. And then, in another one, we also had to do just normal bodyweight jumping split lunges. more of a dance move.
Did you eat? This chick yesterday, all her calories by like 3 o'clock, she fucked up. And then I trained her legs.
All I had left was like a protein shake and 10 grams of peanut butter. But I didn't cave. Why are you recording me? This is my story.
My girlfriend gives me the best chow time in the world. And it just tastes like Milo melted and cold in my teeth.
I'm so good though.
There's no green tea bubbleness.
Why are you recording me? This is my story.
Guys, just stick to green tea and black tea when you get chow time. Chocolate, milk, nah. Nada.
Alright, Kelly, so today's YouTube video's topic is... Oh, my back! Is, do you need supplements to achieve your fitness goals in your dream body?
No, but they help.
If any of you guys like the look of a steroid guy, you need steroids. Okay, but supplements?
Steroids and supplements are two different things.
Okay, I know. We're covering supplements.
Ew, get it off my face.
Okay, so guys, first we're going to go over the protons. Do you need protein out of a supplement to reach your goal?
No.
What should you get your protein from majority of the time?
Meat, eggs,
beans, and chow time.
Cheese, nah. Tuna. What else do I eat?
Protein bars?
Protein bars.
Protein bars are good.
But they're really high in calories though.
But it's still good.
That's the only difference though, between a protein bar and a protein
powder. I was about to say that. Okay, so see this? This has 120 calories and it has 24 grams of protein, rather than, see this big bad boy, this bar, it's 30 grams of protein, bar, it has like 300 and something calories because it tastes so, yeah, it's so good and so delicious. All right, now let's move on to, protein's covered, protein, just eat food and have shakes for if you're cutting. And yeah, but if you're wanting to gain bigger weight, get one of these bad boys. A mass gainer, because they're just loaded with carbs, calories, and everything, and you're gonna grow into a big boy. Alright, let's go over the topic of fat burners because you love your OxyShred. Alright, let me show you what OxyShred looks like. Boom! So that's OxyShred, Kaylee's favorite supplementation.
Not the flavor.
Alright, so why do you take this every day?
Why am I answering the questions? You're the supplement guy.
I don't take fat burners. I was about to cover my shit
well,
after.
Well, I like it because it gives me caffeine in the morning.
So?
A dead zombie in the morning.
This has approximately 150 milligrams of caffeine. Kaylee gets a caffeine kick in the morning from this. I get my 160 milligram caffeine boost from Monster Energy Zero.
I also find that because it's got the L-carnitine in it, I like to have that in the morning when I do fasted cardio, when I do F45.
I don't do cardio,
I don't know if
guys,
it really
so.
Works, but I can't really tell because I'm dieting anyway. I'm dropping weight regardless, so.
Yeah. So, these things help you with mental focus, get you out of bed easier, help you get a bit more sweat on during the day, I believe.
And they also...
suppress appetite.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
I bet ya. But yeah, four major keys of a good fat burner that you should feel. If you don't feel any of that, you're wasting your money. And this isn't going to get you shredded to the bone. You're going to have to get your diet on track. So this shreds...
something you rely on.
Yeah. Diet comes over fat burner. You can't take 10 scoops of that a day and get shredded in like 10 days. Okay. Okay, next topic. Let's go over some BCAA amino energy in 3, 2... and the BCAAs. So these ones I recommend to everybody because I have zero calories. All your BCAAs are loaded, 7 grams of BCAAs. All your other goodness. You got your other little vitamins, you got your carbohydrates, sodium, a little bit for that cheeky pump. You got the electrolytes, which Powerade has as is, so it just helps you recover better, muscle growth, muscle tissue, oh my back, all that sort of good stuff. The reason I take BCAAs when I'm cutting, especially because they're flavored, they taste good, and they help me recover better and make me feel better because they do have a bit of caffeine and green tea extract, some of them. Do you take BCAAs?
Only when I steal yours.
Yeah, you don't really need BCAAs at the end of the day. If you can afford it, they're like a luxury to have for like extra muscle repair, sip on.
Mental focus,
mental gains, and it
something
does.
Something to drink other than water when you're on a diet also.
I was about to say that. So all these have killer flavors, so you can drink like mango water basically all during the day. And
Do they have grape, strawberry, kiwi,
they have everything. But yeah, these are like a little luxurious. Like, I don't personally feel like most of the products help with muscle recovery, but Extend and that sort of stuff really helped me on prep because I was dying. So yeah, get yourself some BCAAs if you're in a very deep caloric deficit or you just are sick of drinking only water. All right, let's go over my favorite supplementations.
My least favorite.
Pre-workout. Major keys are this, that's going to help you in the gym. Go Super Saiyan. If you're feeling tired, it's going to wake you up. Mental focus, pump, all that sort of good stuff. And the beta, the tingles. So why do you use pre-workout?
I don't really use it that much. I only use it when I'm super dead. When I'm really tired. And I want a good workout, but I can't be fucked. So that's when I take it.
I just like going Super Saiyan when I take a scoop of this every day.
Yeah, you take it every day. I don't know how you do it.
Because I work at a supplement store. But yeah, I use this because it's like 300 milligrams caffeine. Most of them, the ones I take, have palm formula, most of them have L-carnitine now, they have like extracts, they have taurine, they have all this crazy shit off of these products now that I don't even know if they actually have it in
it. For anyone who doesn't even know what L-carnitine is, it's like a fat burning ingredient.
Yeah, so you can basically use your pre-workout as a fat burner. Because you sweat twice as more when you take this sort of stuff, I feel like.
I feel like I sweat with OxyShred, which has got L-carnitine in it.
She's
so.
The one, the female.
That one.
I'm just a sweaty wog. I can't feel my shoulder. Anyways, take a pre-workout if you are a gym goer, you work late, you work a lot.
Just don't take pre-workout too late, or you won't sleep.
Trust me, it doesn't really affect me because I sleep like a baby every day. I sleep like 4 or 5
hours.
I know
some people who literally just get so shaken they can't sleep until like ridiculous times in the morning.
Yeah, I was about to say
that. If they take it really late.
If you're not caffeine tolerant.
Or if you don't take pre-workout.
Don't take anything like this, you'll die. Take more like a C4, like the little baby products, all that sort of stuff.
Work your way up.
Yeah, work your way up to the big boy, like 300 milligrams caffeine, all the crazy shit.
Just start off with like a lower stim.
Yeah, so if you, so C4, probably Awaken's good for you. Probably some Defcon, Endo Rush, Hustle. There's a lot of products out there that are just moderate caffeine boosters. No crazy tingles, all that sort of stuff. The more pathogen, Total Wars, all that sort of stuff in Adelaide, they're the crazy stuff that will really get your heart pumping and your sweat. And then a crazy pump will happen and you turn Super Saiyan. But yeah, my girlfriend, for instance, has a really bad side effect that she feels sick a lot of the time when she takes pre-workout. So you may feel that as well. Depends how high stim it is. Me, I can chew it like a candy bar because I love pre-workouts and love the feeling it gives me. That's why I take it.
I hate the flavor of them, like any flavor. I like it. It doesn't matter how good it tastes, it still doesn't taste good.
Outbreak Nutrition, Pathogen, best flavors. Wreckage, pretty good as well. Total War, pretty shit now because they took out DHMA.
See, I wasn't too...
Have you taken a new one?
Yeah, I think so. I think so.
I haven't had the new one, only in sachets.
Okay, maybe I haven't taken the new
one. It tastes like shit though, it makes me sick. That's me.
I always dry scoop anyway, because I hate drinking it when there's like so much water and flavor.
But yeah, so we covered BCAAs, fat burners, protein, pre-workout.
Protein bar, cookies.
I'll show you the best supplement you should have in your diet if you can afford it all the time. Are you ready to see all the supplements you should take? Food. Protein bars, protein cookies, protein bars. That is the one. Because it's food, digestible easier, it tastes killer, and who doesn't like cookies and flavored bars with protein?
These are really good. Well, these are really good, but I can't really eat them because my calories are too low, so.
Alright, so guys, you'll find these products. They say they have protein,
but they're loaded 70% full of carbs.
This one's really deceivable because it's like 16 grams per cookie, but you have to always look at the label because it's actually servings per container too. So they market it as 16 grams of protein for the whole thing, but then you have to look at your carbs. So 32 carbs. They're so you're eating 64 carbs.
Yeah.
In one cookie. Yeah. But they won't even advertise that. They'll just tell you they're 16 grams.
They're the best.
Protein. Liars.
So yeah, these, deceivable. Just make sure they fit in your macros, basically. Same on that stuff.
Not mine. This one's
that's right. Cool.
So these ones are
okay. What, like 2 carbs? Something like that. 5 carbs? 5 carbs.
Yeah.
And that one's still got like 30 something carbs.
36.
Yeah, so these products are very good.
The other low carb one that's good that you don't actually have here is the BSC ones.
Yeah.
The BSC ones.
The lighting in this room is really bad, sorry guys. But yeah, that's a supplement. If you can afford it, chuck some cookies into your diet. These really help for bulking, these cookies here, because they're like 720 calories for one cookie. Beautiful.
All right, creatine. Creatine is one of them things that you're like a 17-year-old kid. You're like, bro, I need the creatine, I need the mass gainer, I need the protein. So creatine really helps with growth because it does pump more blood into the muscle, all that sort of stuff. So that's a really big bonus. I personally haven't ever used creatine in my life, like cycled it, so I don't really know the full effects of it. I've taken it like here and there. I do feel a massive strength increase in my body when I have like taking creatine and all that. So I was like, it's not a steroid. That's a very big conception of creatine. Yeah, a lot of kids are like, oh my god, creatine steroids. Yeah, I've heard it before. Fitness industry, man. But yeah, creatine will help you grow, strength, all that sort of good stuff. Pump blood around your body, pump water around your body, all that good stuff.
It's really about trying to build muscle.
Yeah, build muscle. Was it glutamine? Glutamine, pure carbs, all that sort of stuff. Really helps factor in carbs straight into your body. Just pumps it straight in there when you need to get them carbs in intra-workout, post-workout. It helps with pumps, all that sort of stuff. I'm going to get my friend over to go over test boosters because my test levels are like a 21-year-old still, but he personally uses test boosters, so he'll talk to you on test boosters, the last supplement. But yeah, basically I want to just say that you don't need supplements, but they do help you. I've ever only used is a protein, a pre-workout, and BCAAs. That's all I've ever really relied on or wanted to have because I feel that benefits me because I don't really feel like I need test boosters, creatine, all that sort of stuff. I just eat a lot of food and I get all my nutrients and all that sort of stuff from my food I take in because I eat 3,000 to 5,000 calories a day. So I have a wide range of vitamins I take in from different foods, all that sort of stuff. So yeah. Alright, before my friend goes over the test booster stuff, this is my favorite protein powder because it's amazing.
Is that somebody coming in?
No, so ISO 100 is my favorite protein. Pathogen's favorite pre-workout and Extend's my favorite BCAAs. That's my top three. You know, Kaylee, what are your top three supplements?
Because I'm a stinge. Cytec Nutrition is my protein at the moment. Oxyshred and I'd probably say the Optimum Nutrition BCAAs.
Very cool. Very cool. I want to get the man Adam Craig, who works here at the BSF, who's the sup god, to go over his top three and the test booster thing when he comes in like 10 minutes.
Now and then, where they have the sledgehammer, and instead of actually hitting it, they just bring it down and then they come back up. He's an oracle.
All right, ads. Final part of my video. Best test booster supplementation?
Be Super Test.
Why?
Because it's the most complete testosterone boosting formula.
What does testosterone booster do?
It boosts your natural testosterone levels to put your body in a better state for building muscle, burning fat.
Alright, what's the first thing you guys heard? Natural. Natty.
Natty.
I done. Let's close supplementation talk.
Never shop with your girlfriend on prep. This is what happens. She gets excited over apple pies and fucking cheese. Look at this. This is what prep does to people. I remember this feeling.
They have salted caramel apple crumble.